So let's look at the messaging complexity of the mutual exclusion lock algorithm. The lock primitive, when a process makes a lock request, it sends n minus 1 request messages. Because there are n nodes in the distributed system, there are n minus 1 peers, and so every node has to send a request message to all its peers, so n minus 1 messages are the request messages sent out. And in response to these request messages, every peer is going to acknowledge a request message. So there are going to be n minus 1 messages traversing the network, which are the acknowledgement message for this lock request. And then the process is happy using the lock for the critical section, and it gets to the unlock primitive. And the unlock primitive, once again, we're going to send n minus 1 unlock messages. So the unlock primitive involves sending an unlock message to every one of the peers in the distributed system. So n minus 1 messages are sent out in the network. The interesting thing that you notice is that there is no acknowledgement for the unlock message because of the assumption that we make that messages are never lost. And therefore, when I send an unlock message, I know that everybody will get it, everybody will remove my request from the respective queues and go on with life. And therefore, there is no acknowledgement for that. And so if you count the number of messages that are involved in a lock plus unlock, totally we have 3 to the n minus 1. That's the total number of messages that are incurred. That is the messaging complexity of the distributed mutual exclusion lock algorithm. That begs the question, can we do better? And the answer is yes. And the reason is going back to the condition that I said that is used in making a decision as to whether I won the lock or not. If you recall, I told you that the condition is my request has to be at the top of the queue. And second, I should have either gotten acknowledgments for that request from everybody else, or I've received a lock request from my peers that have a timestamp that is later than my own lock request. If the lock requests that I received from my peers have timestamps that are later than mine, I know that they are going to wait for me to be served before they're going to use the lock. And therefore, what I can do if I am a receiving node for a lock request, when I see a lock request, normally I would go ahead and do an acknowledgement. But when I get a lock request and I see, hey, this guy's lock request is going to be after mine, so I don't have to send an acknowledgement yet. What I can do is wait till I'm actually going to unlock. My unlock itself can serve as the acknowledgement for that particular node that has made a lock request that is later in time than my own. So in other words, we can defer the acknowledgements if my lock request precedes my peer's lock request. So we are combining the acknowledgement for a lock request with the unlock. So if I do that, then I can bring the message complexity down to 2 to the n minus 1. So what we're doing is to get rid of the acknowledgement messages if, in fact, our own lock request is ahead of an incoming request that I see from a peer. That's how we can reduce the messaging complexity of this algorithm to be 2 to the n minus 1. By the way, the distributed mutual exclusion lock problem has been a fertile ground for researchers to think about new algorithms that can shave the messaging complexity even further from this 2 to the n minus 1. And I invite you to look at the literature to see other works that have been done to reduce the message complexity to even smaller numbers than 2 times n minus 1.